It was a common practice for producers, singers, musicians, record companies to have somebody else fronting a very good vocalist. It was a no-brainer.
The producer came up to me and he said, well, here's these two guys and these two guys, and these two are here from Munich, and these two are from, which one do you think? I said, oh, those guys from Munich. Wow, they look great. They were not in the picture until way after the thing started to take off.
I didn't want to be in the front man because I had been on stage many years with so many other different groups, and so I didn't want to be on the stage singing at the time I was 46, 47 years old, but I wanted to make music behind the scene.
The producer called and said, you can do the whole album with us, but keep it quiet. Nobody's supposed to know.
Linda and I were forbidden to be seen with the boys. We were actually forbidden to talk to the boys because the producer and the manager and the record company were all terrified that somebody might slip.
It's like working with smoke and mirrors, and nobody knew what was going on for a long time. It was like David Copperfield couldn't have done it better.
You have two sides. One side you feel good because you're saying, my voice done made it. Number one, worldwide. But you're still sitting in the back and saying, that's not what I really wanted. I wanted to make it.
He had told me that he had another rapper on the project before, but it was some complications. And then he asked me to try it, and I tried it, so I got the job. But I had to stay downstairs until all the musicians left. Nobody should have known that I was there.
The producer's a god. He's one of the top producers in the world, even today. You don't spit in the wind, and you don't screw around with this producer. You just don't.